हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ धर्मेंद्र कुमार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिप्लोमा इन इंजीनियरिंग. आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन कूलिंग सिस्टम ऑफ एन ऑटोमोबाइल. इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट हाउ कूलिंग सिस्टम इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर एनी ऑटोमोबाइल और हाउ कूलिंग सिस्टम इज बेनिफिशियल फॉर एनी टाइप ऑफ व्हीकल like passenger vehicle, like goods vehicle, and varieties of vehicle like two-wheeler, three-wheeler, and multi-wheeler also. Let's start with a new slide. These are the some picture of component of cooling system, like a radiator, upper hose, thermostat, pressure cap, fan, water pump, lower hose and transmission cooling lines. These picture represent the various component of cooling system. It included both type of cooling system, like water cooling system or air cooling system. Now the most important thing is purpose of the cooling system. Why cooling system is needed in any automobile system, or what are the various requirements of cooling system in any automobile? Now let's discuss point wise. It control temperature of any hot combustion. Any hot combustion represent here the rises of temperature around the cylinder during the combustion process, because when combustion process takes place in the cylinder, then it almost temperature rises from 2700 degrees Celsius to 4000 degrees Celsius. Now at this temperature, if we not provide cooling system to whole cylinder system, then it may be brushed, or it may be some occurrence of damaging of any parts, like piston or piston rings, or it may be damage of cylinder valves. So we have to provide enough cooling system around the cylinder. It is by applying the cooling system around the cylinder, it decreases the temperature of it decreases the rising temperature, which increases during the combustion process. The cooling system almost decreases 20% of the heat generation during combustion process. Now the next point is almost 4000 degree temperature could seriously damage the engine parts if you not provided a cooling system. Now the another one is provide heat for passenger compartment. This cooling system also ensure that in the winter season, the transmission of heat around the passenger seats. Cool trains fluid and oils, and heat moves from warm to cold. Actually, the main purpose of cooling system is transmission of heat from hot parts, hot part of the engine to the dissipate in the air or dissipate in the water. It depends on the which type of cooling system we using in that particular automobile. Like either we use air cooling system, or we use water cooling system. Now there are three type of cooling system which we generally use in any automobile, like in goods vehicle or any passenger vehicle. First one is air cooling, then oil cooling, and third one is we can say that water cooling or liquid cooling. Let's discuss about one by one. First one is air cooling system. Air cooling system represent that the occurrence of cooling is totally depend on airs. Like if we take example of bikes, then we see that above the engine parts of bikes, some fins are assembled together. And when we bike start, the air must strike to the fins and transfer of heat from that fins to the air. Normally, the design of fins is normally the design of fins is so calculated that the maximum area of that fins is countered with air which is coming from surrounding or which is coming from upward directions. Means overall cooling is done by air. No any water or liquid cooling is provided to the that particular engine. Directly, indirectly, we use cooling oil, which is also known as in the local language, mobiles or engine oils. It also provide to the cooling of crankshaft, piston rings, and the internal parts of cylinder, a part of consuming contaminated substance. Now, there are the various advantages of air-cooled system. In this type of engine which is using air cooling system, there is no requirement of radiator. In case of water cooling system, there are the leakages, but in this case there are no leakages if you're talking about air cooling system. Basically, these advantages are over the water cooling system. Now the there is no any coolant or antifreeze solution are not required because we will later discuss about water cooling system where we have to use coolant and antifreeze solution as well. Now the fourth advantage of air cooling system is this system can be used in the cold climate where it is water is used for maybe freeze. We can use in that type of weather or in hilly areas where the water normally freezes. Now the two disadvantages of air cooled system. First one is comparatively it is less efficient due to the, when we compare with water cooling system. Now the second point is it is used in aeroplane and motorcycle engine where the engine are exposed to the air directly. The main disadvantage of air cooling system is we have to use this engine where the all engine parts are in the open area like aeroplane or like bikes. But if we are talking about cars, trucks and tempos, we normally see that the engine are housing or it is situated in the casing, like casing like a structure. So there are no chance of counter strike of air. So the air cooling system we only use in where the engine parts are open. Now the water cooling system is here are the only disadvantages. Some advantage of water cooling system is it is more efficient than air cooling system, and if engine is in casing, then water cooling system is very efficient. There is no need of air cooling system. Water cooling system represent usage of water for cooling system, cooling purpose. Now similarly, we have seen in the air cooling system, air is a medium for cooling system, and in water cooling system, water is a medium in water cooling system. Here are some various disadvantages of water cooling system. Like it depends upon the supply of water. The water pump which circulate over water absorb considerable power. because power is required, we use a centrifugal pump to circulate the water around the cylinder, or to circulate the water any parts of the automobile which may be damaged due to the occurrence of heat or due to the rising temperature around that parts of any vehicle. If the the water pump we circulate, that already discussed. The third point is, if the water cooling system fails, then it will result in several damage of engine. If we only depend on a water cooling system, then it may be, if there is a lack of water, then temperature rises and it may be damage some parts where the temperature is higher. The water cooling system is considered that it is more number of parts, also it require more maintenance and the care of each parts, because in the air cooling system we have seen that there is no any auxiliary item or any auxiliary parts have to implemented around the engine. When we are talking about the water cooling system, there is a multiple auxiliary component which is usage in water cooling system, like radiator, centrifugal pump, various pumps, because various pumps are, or if you're talking about particularly four cylinder parts, we have we will see that the cylinder jacket is used around the cylinder for cooling purpose. So we can say that various component we have to use in water cooling system. Now the cooling system parts, here it is represent the only water cooling system parts, like radiator, house clamp, heater return hose, core plug, drain plug, water pump, lower hose, fan, belt for driving the water pump, and this shaft is connected to the crankshaft, and the water pump is associated with crankshaft and run according to the crankshaft, and thermostat housing. These are the various component, various auxiliary component which we have using in water cooling system. Now water jackets we normally use surrounds the cylinder with all water passages. It absorb heat from the cylinder wall. Pumps move water to the radiator, where the heat is exchanged to the air. Now, if we talking about the water cooling system, the function of radiator is to transmit heat, means it dissipate the heat to the surrounding air and chilled that particular valve. Because once we filled the radiator from the water, it circulate whole parts around the all parts which may be damaged due to rising in temperature. Then lastly, when water comes to the radiator after taking heat from that parts, the radiator have various fins which dissipate the heat to the surrounding air. This is, we can say that this is the function of the radiator. Now here is the water pump. It is non-positive displacement pump which circulate coolant around the cooling system. A simple impeller design. If you're talking about multiple choice question, it may be asked that which type of pump is used in a cooling system in automobile. Then surely it is a centrifugal pump, which are normally using in a cooling system of an automobile. It consists simple impeller design and usually driven by the drive belt from the crankshaft, as we discussed earlier. Now here the actual view of the water pump. It is represent, here is the leakage weep hole and noise bearing. These are, it is the actual diagram of the water pump which is using in water cooling system. This is the picture of radiators we have discussed earlier, like these type of fins which dissipate the heat energy to the water. These are the cores, and this is tank for filling the water. it is work like a heat exchanger because it it's dissipate the heat to the surrounding air. Now the tube and fin style are the most popular, made of copper and brass or aluminium and plastic. Normally from here we can choose one also multiple choice question. It may be asked which type of material are using in which type of material are using in for making of radiator, then surely it be a copper. Now the radiator types, two types of radiator construction, downflow and the coarse flow. Downflow is normally used in a older design, or it is a very old design, and the cross flow is nowadays vehicle coming from the from last 5 years, they are using cross flow radiator types. These are the radiator fans. It consists just behind the radiator, keeping air moving through the radiator when the car is not moving. There are the several types of the radiator fans: rigid, flex, and viscous clutch electric motor. This is the thermostat, is the one component using in water cooling system. Control coolant temperature uses a temperature sensor or a valve. Usually opens around at 195 degrees Celsius. This is the function of the thermostat. Now thermostat failure. If it is a fail in the open position, engine run cold, no heat, poor gas mileage, gunks, or motor oil or engine inside. If it is failed close, look out, it create pressure in the engine well beyond the normal limit. Many types of damage may be occur if thermostat will failure, because it sense the temperature and send to the relative component to do a cooling part of that any component which have a rises temperature or heat, which is getting heat. Now this is the radiator cap. The cap allow access to the cooling system for the filling and testing. The cap has two valves, one a pressure relief valve set at around 15 psi and a vacuum valve which is need when the engine cooling down. A raises boiling point of fluid and it able to take on the more heat. Now this is the coolant recovery tank. In the earlier we have discussed about coolant and antifreeze solution which we are using in a water cooling system. The function of the coolant recovery tank is it keeps the coolant level fill in the system at all times. Work in conjunction with the radiator cap. When the engine heat up the coolant, when the engine heat up, the coolant expand and flow to the recovery tank. And when the engine coolant, the coolant contract and create a vacuum and draw the fluid back into the radiator. Reduce air in the system, reduce rust, and less need to open radiator. If you use coolant or antifreeze solution regularly, then it may be we have to less requirement of open a radiator. Coolant temperature center, we normally know as a CTS, report to the computer, means report to the related component. It may be work as a gauge. Here the location of the CTS is block, head and radiator tank. Block here, it represent the cylinder block or cylinder heads and the radiator tanks, because cylinder is the most hot part. If you're talking about a running engine, then cylinder is the most hottest part in any engine, because combustion takes place at that point or that in cylinder. Now the one component is a fan sword. It causes the air to be the channeled through the radiator, making the radiator more efficient. Also provides safety from the spinning fan blades. This is the heater. The hot water in the cooling system is used to warm the passenger compartment in the winter season if you needed heat to the passengers. A small radiator called a heater core is located in the dais area. A heater houses directly direct the hot water and form it. There is an overall picture of the heating system. Now we have talking about the various coolants, the necessity of the coolant. Here we discuss some point about coolants, several type of antifreeze available. Normally here we can pick one multiple choice question also. Ethyl glycol, most common coolant and antifreeze solution uses in the water cooling system. Dexol, it rains and it lasts to up to 5 years. And propylene glycol, it is non-toxic solution. Radiator houses and the heater houses. The upper and the lower radiator houses direct the fluid from engine to the radiator and back to the engine. Then radiator houses are a special part to the each other. Radiators, heaters, it work as a bypass to the radiator and between engines. Heater houses do same for the heater cores. Now the cooling system service, if you're talking about the service of that component, system inspection, winterization, and the cooling system flushing. Now the cooling system inspection consists following topics or check following component in the engine. If you're talking about the inspection of cooling system, basically we are talking about the cars, four-wheeler vehicle, where the engine is kept under the housing. Check control level, check antifreeze protection, check coolant condition, check coolant pH, leak check system, check radiator cap, check belt tension, check belt condition, check hose condition, blowout radiator fins, check thermostat, check radiator fans, and check water pump. Means we can say that if we inspect the cooling system, then we have to check each and every component which is associated with water cooling system. This is the term utilized normally in the automobile sector. Winterize term used by the repair industry, it usually means a cooling inspection plus a coolant flush. Now here in if water pump is damaged or it needs a replacement of water pump, then here is a method for a replacing of water pump. Now the replacement is done by point to point. First one is drain cooling system, remove houses, remove pump and gasket, install new pump and gasket, attach house and belt, and refill the check system. These are the steps of replacing a water pump in a water cooling system. Now here are the some MCQs. First one is during combustion in the engine, temperature in the cylinder rises up to. In the we have discussed in the second or third slide, the temperature rises from approx 400 4000 degrees Celsius. Then answer is fourth one, 30 approx. If 4000 is not given in the option, then it may be considerable up to 3700 degrees Celsius. Now the second multiple choice question is, in an internal combustion engine, about a space of the latent heat produced during the combustion passes through the cylinder wall into the cooling system. The question is saying that how much latent heat produced during the combustion passes through cylinder wall into cylinder jacket. We have seen that in previous PPT, cylinder jacket is using around the cylinder for cooling the cylinders. I have told earlier, about 20% of the heat dissipated to the or transferred to the cylinder basket, which we are using around the cylinder. And the option is second option, 20%. Now we can say that in an internal combustion engine, about 20% of the latent heat produced during combustion passes through the cylinder wall into cooling system. Now the third of multiple choice question is, in motorcycle, the following types of cooling system is used. We have discussed that one type is air cooling system and another type is water cooling system. If you're talking about air cooling system, then we have discussed that air cooling system is beneficial where the overall engine parts in the open space and the strike of air must be drawn on the engine. Then if you're talking about motorcycle, because in question given that in motorcycle which type of cooling system is used, it is asking. Then we have seen that in any motorcycle, engine part is located at the outside and the surrounding airs. And if we using bike or any motorcycle, then we have seen that air strikes on the engines. For that, a strike of more air to the engines or a striking of more air to the engine, we have seen that the fins type of area located on upper parts of the engine. Then we can say that in motorcycle, we are using only air cooling system. Now the fourth one MCQ is, in water cooling system, the water in the jacket obtain heat from cylinder due to. It is saying that if you're talking about water jackets which we are using around the cylinders, then which type of method used to transfer heat from cylinder to water of water jacket, which is associated with a cylinder. Now this is all termed with physics, related to the physics. Now the answer is conduction, because in the conduction process, transfer of heat from one molecule to the another, which is considerable, attached to each other, because we have seen that heat created in the cylinder during the combustion process, it drawn to the goes to the water from the cylinder to the cylinder jacket, because the temperature of the water in the cylinder jackets is very low compared to the temperature of cylinder during combustion time or during running time. Now we can see that conduction is that only process which is using at the medium of transfer heat from cylinder to the cylinder jacket or cylinder to the water jacket around the cylinder, which is associated with around the cylinder. Now the fourth question is, in water cooling system with pump circulation system, the following pump is used. We have discussed earlier in the pump section that centrifugal pump is using in water cooling system for pump the water, and it is responsible for the circulating of the water from radiator to the all parts of or all components of the engine, which may be damaged during due to the rises of temperature, and it ensures that the circulation of water is done through the radiators. Surely the option A is the suitable answer for this multiple choice question. Now the third sixth one is, the radiator is usually made of, we have already discussed that which component is using for making of a radiator. Then copper is the one copper content is maximum, however aluminium, plastics are also using in making of radiator, but the quantity of copper is more. Here, there is a two option given. Then we are surely going with the copper. Galvanized iron, we are not using in making radiators, and stainless steel, this is not, this is also not using of making a radiator. However, some amount of the aluminium with mixing with the copper, we are using with the making of radiators. Then our answer is B. If the copper is not in the option, not in the any option, then we surely go with the aluminium. But here aluminium is also given and copper is also given. These two are, and these two C and D are not relevant to the our answer. Then we have chosen the maximum quantity which is using in the making of radiator. Then surely it will be a copper. Then we will go through the copper only. Then our answer is B. Now the seventh one is, in a space radiator, each tube contained individual fin surrounding in it. In the diagram of the radiators, we have seen that only gilled type of fins associated with the radiator, which ensure the maximum amount of heat dissipate into the water, air. Now the eighth one is, the cooling fan is, here the it is asking about the place where cooling fan is located, or where cooling fan is associated along with the another component of the engine. The first point is fitted between the engine and the radiator, driven by belt and pulleys, driven from the camshaft, all of the above. It not only about fitting also, two statement here also are given, the driven by belt and pulleys and the driven from the camshaft. Normally, in this question, for answer of this question, we are going through the all of above, because the cooling fan is fitted between the engine and the radiator. We have already talked about the cooling fan associated just below the radiator, because when cooling fan is moving, it ensure the maximum amount heat dissipating into the air, and it also driven by the belt and pulleys, because if we are not using belt and pulleys, then there is no another component which runs that cooling fan. And third is, it is driven from the camshaft. It is driven from the camshaft. Then we can say that all three statements are true regarding this cooling fan. Then we are surely go through the all of above option. Now the third one MCQ is, the following is considered as the best antifreeze solution. When we are talking about in a previous slide antifreeze solution or coolant, then the first antifreeze solution or the first coolant we have read about, ethyl glycol. You can see that in previous slide I have already discussed about ethyl glycol, which is the best considerable antifreeze solution to the uses in the water cooling system. Here some properties, if you are talking about some properties of the ethyl glycol, then surely it must be dissolved in the water, because water is circulating medium around the engine parts. Then we can say that the requirement of any antifreeze solution is, it must dissolve in the water. We can say that the answer of ninth MCQ is ethyl alcohol, which we have discussed already earlier. Now the third one, 10th one is multiple choice question is, the following types of thermostatic valve is fitted with liquids as acetone. We have talked about thermostatic valve, which ensure about regulation of cooling water around the components. Then the answer is bellows type of a thermostatic valve is fitted with liquids such as acetone. This is the overall about cooling system of an automobile. If we if I summarize this chapter, then in this chapter we have learnt about what is cooling system, how it is beneficial for any automobile or any type of vehicle, either it is a goods vehicle or it is passenger vehicle, the types of cooling system. In the type of cooling system, we have seen that the two types, air cooling system and water cooling system. We have seen that various advantages and disadvantages of air cooling system, and also water cooling system. After that, we have seen that there is no auxiliary component which is which we have to used in air cooling system. Only one thing is remember. Only one thing is normally uses in air cooling system. The area of outer engine parts is much more, so that the maximum air strike to the that outer part of engine. If you're talking about the motorcycle engine, then we have seen that various fins like a structure just upper to the engine parts. And after that, we have seen regarding multiple components of water cooling system, a requirement of water cooling system, because if you're talking about four wheelers and three wheelers, engine is housing under the cabin, and there is no reach of air, so that we have to use, or we are using, water cooling system. We have seen various component of water cooling system like thermostat, water pump, fan, radiators, and we have seen various function of these type of parts. Now in the last we have discussed 2-3 auxiliary points like coolants or antifreeze, and the maintenance of cooling system or inspection of cooling system. If you're talking about inspection of cooling system, then which what point are considerable during the inspection of cooling system? This is the overall of the cooling system of an automobile. Now in the next chapter, we will discuss something more interesting than cooling system and automobile. Thank you all. Hello everyone. In this video lecture, we will discuss about drilling machine, various types of drilling machine, and the various applications of drilling machine, and overall how many types of process we can occur with the help of drilling machine. This is our content of this video lecture, like introduction, working principle, construction, a specification for portable drilling machine, types of drilling machine, and various operation performed on drilling machine. This is the basic introduction about drilling machine. The drilling machine or drill press is one of the most common and the useful machine process in industry for producing, forming and finishing hole in a workpiece. The unit essentially consists of a spindle which turns the tool, we are generally called drill tool, which can be advanced in the workpiece either automatically or by the hand. A work table which holds the workpiece rigidly in opposition. Here are the basic
diagram of drilling machine, it consists following parts like base, table, which is used for putting workpiece, a spindle, which is used for applying here drill bit, sleeves, column, which is a stand for with a stand of overall drill machine, and the hair heads is associated with the upper part of the drilling machine. Here is the picture of drill bit or a tool drill. It represent cutting motion of the tool, fixed workpiece, and here we can see in this picture how drilling is done with the help of drill machine. The working principle is the rotating edge of the drill exert a large force on the workpiece, and the hole is generated. The removal of metal in a drilling operation is by shearing and extrusion. Usage of drilling machine is used to drill blind and through the holes in the workpiece. Construction of the drilling machine. Here are the various components associated with the drilling machine: base, column, table, spindle, wheel support, wheel, spindle, and the drill head. Here servo motor are employed for feeding the drill bit onto the workpiece. The machine has only a hand feed mechanism for feeding the tool into the workpiece. This enables the operator to feel how the drill is cutting, and accordingly he can control the down feed pressure. Here is the constructional detail of the drilling machine. Like simplest form of drilling machine is known as bench drilling machine. The simplest type of sensitive drilling machine is shown in figure. This is used for light duty drilling work. This machine is capable to drill hole up to 12.5 mm diameter. Here is the some basic component associated with the drilling machine, like motor. An electric motor supplies the required driving force to a stepped pulley. Base is the bottom part of the machine in which the column is fitted upright. Feed handle is provided to feed the drill into the workpiece. A rake and the pinion mechanism is provided to drive the chuck. Column is the main cylindrical part of the drill machine on which the other component are mounted. Here is the this is known as the column of the drill machine. Belt guard is the provided to cover the belt and pulley drive mechanism to minimize the hazard of the accident. This is the here we can employ the belt guard. This is known as the belt guard, and this is the belt. Here is servo motor is associated, and with the help of this belt, here the responsible of moving of a spindle is carried out by with the help of this belt. Chuck is provided to hold the drill of different size up to 6.5 mm. Drill size more than 6.5 mm are to be fitted directly into the Morse taper of the spindle. Work table, workpiece are mounted and held in the position by the table. This table can be lifted for drilling at an angle. Here is the table clamp, and this is known as the table on which we are putting workpiece. This is known as chuck, in which we are employed drill bit for drilling operations. Chuck is associated with the spindle, and a spindle is associated with the spindle clamp. Here is depth adjustment is associated, which we are using for the adjustment of the depth. Now here is another type of drilling machine, is portable drilling machine, which we are using in generally for household purposes. It is a very small, compact, and self-contained unit carrying a small electric motor inside it. It is very commonly used for drilling holes in such components that can't be transported to the shop due to their size or weight, or where lack of space does not permit their transportation to the bigger type of drilling machine. In such cases, the operation is performed on the site or in the houses or for the household purpose. We using portable electric drilling machines. This is known as sensitive or bench drill machine. This type of drilling machine is used for very light work. Its construction is very simple and it is operations are very easy to perform. We can employ here less skilled person for drilling purpose. It consists, as shown in a figure, of a cast iron having a fixed table over it. Radial drilling machine. This machine is very useful because of its wider range of action. Its principal uses is in drilling holes on such work is difficult to handle frequently. With the use of this machine, the tool is moved to the desired position instead of moving the work to bring the latter in the position for drilling operation. Another type is a gang drilling machine. With the help of gang drilling machine, we associated the multiple spindle drilling machine on a single bench and arranging in a row sequence. These spindles may be driven either separately or collectively. This machine is very useful when the nature of work is such that a number of operations like drilling, reaming, counter boring, and tapping are to be performed in succession on it. Various operations we are performing with the help of drilling machine, like drilling, reaming, boring, counter sinking, spot facing, and tapping. We will discuss one by one. Drilling, it is the main operation done on the machine. It is the operation of producing a circular hole in a solid metal by means of a revolving tool called drill. Boring, it is an operation used after for drilling operation, and the main purpose of boring is enlarging a hole which is carried out by drilling operation. Countersinking, it is the operation used for enlarging the end of a hole, give it a conical shape for a short distance. These are the example of drilling, boring, and countersinking. Reaming, it is the operation of finishing a hole to bring to accurate size and have a finish, better surface finish. This operation is performed by means of a multi-tooth tool called reamer. We can use a reaming process for the better internal surface finish. Counter boring, this operation is used for enlarging only a limited portion of the hole is called counter boring. Tapping, it is the operation done for forming internal threads by means of the tool called tap. This is overall from the drilling operations or drilling machine. In this chapter, we have seen that what is drilling machine, working principle of drilling machine, various components associated with drilling machine, various types of drilling machine according to its application, and the various types of operation which we are performing on by the help of drilling machine, like reaming, counter boring, tapping, counter sinking, drilling, and boring operation. Now in the next lecture, we will discuss about another machining process, Thank you all.